Get ready for the countdown. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Welcome to this week's edition of Brooklyn Junior High School News. My name is Kira.
And my name is Antonio.
Here are your upcoming events.
On January 23rd, there will be a wrestling meet at Brooklyn Junior High and a healthy cooking class and an internet basic workshop.
On January 24th, there will be a PTA meeting at the middle school, a yoga class at Brooklyn Junior High, and a Bollywood dance class at Brooklyn Middle School.
On January 25th, there will be a district-wide spelling bee at Longwood and a girls' volleyball game and a field trip, The Colorful of Justice, Ms. Mailer and Ms. Staffel, and a girls' volleyball game home.
I hope you guys can attend these events.
Hi, my name is Simone, and here are the birthdays for the week of January 20th. Diamond on January 20th, Patrick on January 21st, Caleb also on January 21st, Imani on January 22nd, and Reginald on January 24th. Happy birthday to you all.
Birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you, my friend. Happy birthday to you.
Follow your first period class's progress on the Great Puppy Race and the chart in the cafeteria. Remember, your class receives one puppy for every $5 it raises. And here are some more information on the Seeing Eye Dogs.
Seeing Eye is a very special place.
It's awesome.
An amazing place.
The Seeing Eye is the best place to come for a guide dog.
The Seeing Eye was founded by two innovative Americans, Dorothy Harrison Eustace and Morris Frank. In the 1920s, Mrs. Eustace was living in Switzerland, breeding and training German shepherds for police work. It was during this time that she saw something astonishing in Germany. Dogs were being trained to become new eyes for veterans who had lost their sight in the First World War. Mrs. Eustace was so impressed by the skill of these dogs and by the confidence of their blind owners that she wrote an article about her experience. It was published in the Saturday Evening Post under the title, The Seeing Eye. Millions read the article, but the story could have ended right there if not for Morris Frank, a college student and insurance salesman from Nashville, Tennessee. Blind since the age of 16, Frank wrote to Mrs. Eustace explaining that he would do anything for one of these dogs. She invited him to her home in Switzerland, where he became the first blind American to regain his independence through the help of a dog guide. His success led to a bold idea, an American school that would teach blind people how to achieve the same degree of independence as those with normal sight.
We rely on the generosities of others, either in terms of dedicating their time as a volunteer, as a puppy raiser, or in other capacities, or dedicating financial resources to us so that we can do our mission. I think it's clear the benefits of our mission and the difference we make in the lives of people who are blind across the United States and Canada. We're only able to do that through the support we receive from individuals who believe in our mission and who believe in providing increased independence and dignity to people who are blind through the use of Seeing Eye Dogs.
Please only access appropriate sites.
Please ask the teacher for permission to print.
Please only press the print function once.
Please keep the computer settings the same and don't change them.
Please raise your hand if you have a question.
Please be respectful of people online and offline.
Please treat equipment with respect.
Please not eat candy or food in the learning center or computer area.
Please be respectful of all books and materials.
Hi, my name is Mariana. Here at Brookwood Junior High School, we would like to recognize the Teachers of the Month. The two teachers are Mr. Schmalz and Mrs. Staffel. Mr. Schmalz teaches 8th grade social studies. Mrs. Staffel teaches 7th and 8th grade language arts. Congratulations to you both.
The gym classes have really been working out with their new Insanity workout. Here they are, staying in shape.
When your knee comes up, core is nice and tight. You feel good? Focus and go. Nice and slow. Down. Hit. Bang knees sliding you. Down. Down. Exhale. Down. My core is contracting. This is that move. Push. Keep moving. 3, 2, push. Dig through, y'all. Come on. Come on. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 4, 3.
Next up, we have the highlights from the boys' basketball game against Lansing on January 11th.
Brookwood participated at a speech festival at Colin Path.
Peace, I, and Chanel are competing in a duet acting and received a superior rating.
Simone L. and Olenife A. also received a superior rating for a duet acting.
Cleona H. and Jassy received an excellent rating in their duet acting.
Morgan M. and Kirsten W. were awarded a superior rating for their duet acting.
Chanel R. and Peace I. both performed poetry that they wrote.
All students put on an excellent performance.
On Friday, January 13th, Brookwood Junior High held our school-wide spelling bee. For 7th grade, Malachi J. came in second, Aaron S. came in first. And in 8th grade, Mariana K. came in second, and Kirsten W. came in first. Congratulations.